Hi, this is Ryan from Kixie, and I'm going to be showing you how to set up a power list. A power list is a list of leads or contacts you can dial through automatically using the Kixie PowerDialer. To start, navigate to your Kixie dashboard by clicking on your name in the top left corner of the Kixie dialer, or go to app.kixie.com in your browser. Inside your dashboard, select Manage and then Power List in the menu on the left side of your screen. Next, click New Power List in the top right corner. First, give your power list a name. The active toggle activates or deactivates the power list. If a power list is inactive, no agents will be able to call from that list. If auto start on login is toggled on, agents will automatically start power dialing that list as soon as they log in. Otherwise, agents will have to start the power dialing session manually. Must disposition calls requires agents to disposition every answered call before they can move on to their next call. If a contact in the power list does not have an owner in the CRM, assign to agent on answer will automatically assign contact ownership to the first agent that calls the contact via power dial. Override owner on answer will change contact ownership to whoever calls that contact first, even if there is an existing owner for that contact in your CRM. If owned, only dial from owner will allow the owner of a contact to call that contact. If the contact has no owner in the CRM, the call will be randomly assigned via round robin. Seconds before timeout determines the amount of time a call will ring unanswered before it is disconnected automatically. Dial at a time is the number of contacts that will be called simultaneously. The specific power dialer plan an agent is on will override this number on an agent-by-agent basis. For example, let's say you have three agents assigned to a power list. Agent A has the single-line power dialer, Agent B has the four-line power dialer, and Agent C has the 10-line power dialer plan. If you set dial at a time to 7, Agent A's power dialer will call one number at a time, Agent B's will call four numbers at a time, and Agent C will call 7 at a time. Max attempts per day is the number of calls that will be allowed to go through a single number in a 24-hour period via the power list. Min duration before call retry sets the minimum amount of time before calls to any one contact. Once you have selected your preferred settings, select power list hours from the left-hand menu to move on to the next step. Power list hours has two sections, power list hours and target hours. Power list hours determines the hours and days which your agents can call from the power list. These hours are based on your account's time zone, which can be set in your account settings under Manage Account. Target hours determines what hours agents can call contacts based on the contact's time zone. The contact's time zone is determined by their area code or country code. For example, if your target hours are set from 9 to 6 Monday through Friday, agents will only be able to call New York area codes between the hours of 9 to 6 Eastern Time, whereas Los Angeles area codes will only be able to be called between 9 to 6 Pacific Time. London phone numbers in this example will only be able to call between 9 to 6 Greenwich Mean Time. Once you've set your power list hours and target hours, select Upload Data from the left side menu. In the Upload Data section, first choose how you want duplicates to be handled. If this is the first file you are uploading, it doesn't matter what option you choose, but we'll go over it anyway. Duplicates are based off of a phone number. If you select Overwrite, any contacts uploaded with a phone number that is a duplicate of a contact already in the system will be overwritten by the newly uploaded contact. If Ignore is selected, duplicates will be excluded from the upload. If Merge is selected, any blank fields in the original contact will be filled with any information in the same fields on the newly uploaded duplicate contact. After selecting your duplicate handling rules, you may select the file you would like to upload. You can upload a spreadsheet in CSV file format or in either of the two Excel file formats. Click Select File under Upload Data and select the CSV file you wish to upload. Then click Open. Your CSV data will be uploaded and mapped using our PowerList mapping tool. Make sure to match the headers from your upload to the correct Kixie categories. Mapping a phone number to the Kixie phone number field is required. The default fields the PowerDialer includes are phone number, email, first name, last name, title, company name, next call refresher, CRM user ID, and CRM contact ID. With the PowerList, you also have some custom fields to use for unique custom data that your business would like to display while power dialing. Next, navigate to the Dispositions tab where you can set SMS template rules and disposition rules. The options in the Max SMS Sent Per Template section determine how many SMS messages can be sent in the specified time period for a given SMS template. This helps to ensure that your numbers or text messages are not blocked or flagged as spam by cell phone providers as a result of sending out too many of the same text message in a short period of time. For more information on how to avoid having your messages blocked or flagged as spam, please see our help article titled SMS Best Practices to Avoid Being Blocked. Disposition rules are used to trigger specific actions based off of a particular disposition. There are four action options: send SMS template, remove from power list, forward to cadence, and forward to power list. To add another disposition rule, click the blue icon to the right of the last disposition rule. To delete a disposition rule, click the red trash can icon. You may create as many disposition rules as you like. Last but not least, click into the Members tab to add team members to your power list. To learn how to set up teams, please see our help article titled How to Create and Manage Kixie Teams and Review Team Reporting. Select a team from the drop-down menu or start by typing the team name. After you've selected the team for the power list, click the blue Add button. Finally, select Save to save your progress and create the power list. The power list will then appear automatically in the power dialers of the agents it's assigned to. And that's how you set up a power list in Kixie. Thanks for watching.